Hi guys, if you want to see how to create this Beetlejuice inspired makeup, stay tuned. Hi, I'm Ross, I'm here with ACMU, and today I'm going to show you how to do a glamorous Beetlejuice inspired makeup. So we're going to start on with the eyes. So for the first product I'm going to use the Jumbo Eye Pencil in Melt from NYX. It's going to help even out the colour of the eyelids, and also because it's white, it'll help the colours we put on top show off more. You don't have to go in with it in a particular way, you can be quite messy with it, because we're going to clean up round it afterwards. Again. So to help blend that out, I'm going to use a beauty blender. It can be one of your choices, not a particular brand. And you can have it damp or dry. It's just up to you. So once that is done and evenly spread out over the eyelids, we're going to go in with a fluffy brush. It can be any kind of brand again, and we're going to go in with a pure white eyeshadow just to set the cream base down. Now all that is set, we're going to go in with the eyeshadow. So for the eyeshadow, I'm going to use primarily the Urban Decay Electric Palette. And for this look, you only need really three eyeshadows, a light and a dark purple and a black. So I'm going to go in with a smaller fluffy brush and go in with this kind of dark, this medium, oh wait, this light purple. So we're going to put that through the crease and blend up towards the brows. What I like to do to help blend out the edges of the eyeshadow is use a clean fluffy brush just to help blend it all together. Now that the first colour of the eyeshadow is all blended out, we're going to go in with the deeper purple. This is this kind of colour in the palette. I'm going to use this from the outer corner into halfway through the crease just to add more definition. And you can go in with the previous brush you used for the previous colour as well. What I like to do for this is just stamp it into the crease and then blend it out to add more pigmentation to the look. And with this previous brush you used to help blend out everything, you can just use that again. Now that the purple eyeshadow is done, we're going to use a black just to add more darkness and definition to the outside of the eye. You don't have to use a certain brand of black, just any kind of generic black will do fine. Just tap off the excess if you put too much on the brush. What I like to do is tap it on and then blend it out to add more of a smoky effect to the outside of the eye. Now that the eyeshadow is done, I'm going to go in and clean up the outside of the eye. For this, you could use a simple baby wipe or a makeup wipe of your choice, it doesn't really matter. So to create this the kind of harsh line is just using a makeup wipe and just halfing it over on your finger and going from the outer corner up towards the end of the brow. So like that, and just do that on the other side. Now that that's done, we're gonna go in and start creating the cut crease. So for this, I'm gonna go in with our green liquid lipstick from Jeffree Star. This is Crocodile Tears, I believe. Yes, and I'm going to show you how to do an easy cut crease. If you don't have a liquid lipstick, you could use a concealer and put green eyeshadow over the top of it, or any kind of green based product you think of using. So an easy way to do a cut crease is by getting the product and doing it like putting on like an eyeliner just from the inner corner till halfway through the eye, and then blink and it'll transfer up to where the crease will be. And just blink and it shows up close where you put the crease. Just go back in with a little bit more. Don't worry about under the eye, you can use a makeup wipe to clean all that up afterwards. So now that's done, just clean up under the eye. So now that's done, we're going to go ahead and blend the edges of the cut crease. So an easy way to do that is to go in with the darker purple colour that you used previously on a big fluffy brush and just tap on the edge of the crease. While the liquid lipstick in the eye is dry, we're going to go in with a little bit of skin prep. So what I like to do is use the B6 spray from Urban Decay. Helps with any oils in the skin and helps reduce redness in the skin as well. I like to drench my face and the whole thing with the whole... I'll just use the fan. So now the liquid lipstick is fairly set, we're going to go in with an Urban Decay liquid liner. This is in colour Stage Dive. It's a really good pigmented glitter, so it is. So what we're going to just do is put that all over the cut crease. Now that the glitter's all done, we're going to go in with the foundation. I'm going to go in with the eyes after the base is done. So, for a foundation, I'm going to use this white foundation by LA Girl. Normally this is used just to mix in with other foundations to make them lighter. You could also use a white-based face paint, or you could use a cream-based face paint as well. So I'm going to go in with a dense foundation brush and just pump the foundation straight onto the brush. Dot all over the face. Don't worry about streaks right now, because later on we'll go in with the beauty blender to blend everything together. And make sure you get right down the neck to where the costume you'll be wearing later on will be. All over the lips. Now to go in with a beauty blender. You can go back in with the brush to add more coverage under the eyes. There we go. Now that the foundation is on, we're going to go in with a loose setting powder. So now, there we go. So we're going to go in with loose powder now to set the face. So what I like to do is go under the eyes and over the nose with loose powder, and for the rest of the face just use a pressed powder. I'm just going to go in with the beauty blender just for the loose powder. Now, using a fluffy brush, just going to go in with this press powder. There we go. No. With the fluffy brush, just go under the eye and brush away all the excess powder. So now we're going to go in with another spray, and let's use the All Nighter spray from Urban Decay. It just helps lock everything in place. Just use the fan again. There we go, that's all set. So now we're going to go in with contour. Normally for contour you'd go with brown or a colour that would match your skin tone, but today I'm going to go in with a green, just using a kind of darker green matte shade to help sculpt the face. So we're going to go in under the cheekbones, the round the jawline and on the forehead. You don't have to be very the contour doesn't need to be very blended out, because if it's more messy, it'll just add more to the look. I like to go in with a big fluffy brush like this. It might put people off straight away, but I think it gets the product on very easily and it helps blend it out as you go along as well. Get my hair out of the way. As you can see, I'm being a little bit messier on the forehead with the contour, just because it'll add more dimension to the look. So now to add more glamour to the look, we're going to go in with a highlighter. So I like to use this Makeup Obsession highlighter. It's £3 in Boots and it works very well. Just go in with a small fan brush. So I'm going to go on to the top of the cheekbones, on the tip of the nose and on the Cupid's bow. And now with an angled fluffy brush, I'm going to go in with a lighter green just to contour the nose. So for the under eye, we're just going to do a similar pattern to how we did with the top of the eye. Just use the lighter purple around the lash line, then blend it down, and in right at the waterline, I'm going to use the darker purple. So with a small lip brush, just this is the one I like to use, and with a black gel liner, we're going to go into the waterline. I think the easiest way to do this is just to go for it. It's much easier doing that. There we go. And just do that on the other eye. So just with the brush I previously used for eyeshadow, just going to use that on the waterline to help blend the eyeliner down. So now that the eyeliner is blended out, we're going to go in with the lips. So for the lips, what we're going to do is just do a plain black lip, and on the bottom lip we're going to create white stripes. So for this I'm going to go in with a cream based black, but with this you could do could use a black gel eyeliner, you could go in with an actual black lipstick if you had one. If you do struggle doing lips, you could go in with a brush like this. It will help you a lot going in the corners of the lips. Because I'm used to doing lips with any brush, I'll just use this one instead. Now to set the grease paint that I've used for the lips, I'm going to go in with just a plain black eyeshadow. By setting the lips, it'll actually help the lips stay on longer throughout the night. So now we're going to go in and do the bottom lip. So for this, only thing you need is a small detail brush like this. You can use a simple paintbrush. You can get at any really craft shop. And you could use water for this, but I'm just going to use setting spray. Just that's what I've got to hand. And with this, I'm just going to create stripes going down the lip. To stop the white from transferring, just use a white eyeshadow just to set it down so it'll stop it from transferring to the upper lip. So now we're going to go in and add more dimension to the face. So I'm going to go in with a green water activated face paint and just the setting spray again. Just spray it straight onto the pan and then use the stipple sponge to go all over the contours and little patches of the face to add more of a dirty look. Don't have to be very, very neat with this either. I'm going to go in just at the side of the lip and make it look like it's running down my face. So to add more dimension to the look, I'm gonna go in with a grey water activated face paint. So now I'm gonna go in with a little bit of mascara just to open up the eyes. There it is. And that is the whole makeup. Now we're going to move on to the hair and the costume. So what I'm going to do is use hairspray, just spray my whole head and mess up my hair really, really quickly. So the hair is just up and a little bit messy. We're going to go in with a green hairspray. You could find this anywhere in the high street around Halloween time anyway. I don't want to mess up the background. That's fine. So now that the hairspray's on, what I'm going to do is to make sure the hair is locked into place is spray more hairspray on top. I'll wait till I'll off it. I can taste the hairspray. There we go. So now the hair is all done, we're going to move on to the clothing. Now, if I go and get the stuff. Am I in? Oh, wait. So what I've done to finish off the look is wear a white and black printed shirt. It could be really anything because it's just an inspired look. And also I've added on a black leather jacket. Hope you enjoyed this. Make sure that you subscribe and like to ACMU to see more colourful looks like this. Bye.